Hello, good afternoon and mabuhay from the Philippines. I'm Arnalee. So I will be presenting one of the 7,000 plus reasons why it's more fun in the Philippines. So I like to travel and I like to hike, I like to bike, and so I also love mapping. So yeah, I thought I will do mapping while traveling. So let me present to you Batanes, the home of the winds. Yeah. So some quick facts. It's in the northernmost part of the Philippines. Actually, Taiwan is nearer Batanes than the main island Luzon, and it has 10 islands, 3 of which are the main islands. So Itbayat, Basco, Bataan, and Sabtang. So there are no too slow internet connection there. So if you wanna get disconnected to the world, so you can go there. And yeah, we call it the Paradise of the North. So it's famous for the lighthouses, stone houses. And yeah, so I get pictures while we're traveling. So I had 1,651 and I trim it down to 210 items. And using JOSM, I map the JTAG photos. So yeah, this is Sabtang Island. It's a 30-minute boat ride from the main island, Bataan. So I map structures in the beach. This is one of the most scenic view there. I also map schools and gift shops, stone houses, and then I also add names to the street. It's surprising the streets there have been digitized. I also map another store, and then I also map the Bataan Island. The highest point, which is Mount Iraya, can be seen there. So while we hike, there's a tree there that gives a sign of 500 meters. So it means that we're 500 meters from the peak. I also map the jump off and another spot where you can take a good picture with Mount Iraya. Also shelter port. So they use this port for storing the boats. So the last island is Itbayat Island. We map the highest point there where you can see other islands, and also you can see Taiwan from there. I also map ports where you can see the Blue Lagoon and have nice pictures of the sunrise. Yeah. So this one is Kavaiwan Lake. So they call it the disappearing lake because it disappears when it's summer season. So yeah, these are my learnings and ways forward. So there are still lots to be mapped, and Philippines has no ID tags for traffic signs. Mapping building footprints will help generate accurate exposure layers to overlay with hazard areas. And we need more visibility for remote areas, because in the Philippines, we have mapped only the urban and city areas. So there, I'm leaving you with a quote from a movie. So it just said that Batanes is meant to be experienced, not to be Googled. So gracias. Maraming salamat.
So, how long have you been mapping in OSM, and what was the most difficult thing for you to learn OSM mapping? How long have you been mapping in OSM?
How long?
How long, yes. How many years or months?
I've been mapping for 2 years.
And what was the most difficult thing for you to learn mapping in OSM?
The most difficult will be mapping the building footprints, because I had a project, previous project, where we should map 15 provinces, and there are lots of slums in the Philippines, so it's hard to map those polygons. Yeah.